video session, we are going to see that how to differentiate a soft link and the hard link. So let's see that what does mean by the soft link and the hard link. So before jumping into this exact topic, so we have to know a little bit the background about the inodes. So what does mean by the inodes and how the inodes will be populated on the hard disks and how that will be useful to know about this information. Okay, let's see over here. Whenever you create any file system on the Linux machine, let's say that will create a few block types, that is called master block, the boot block, and the next one is the super block, third one is the inode block, fourth one is the data block. Okay, in this video session I'm not going to explain this master block or super block or data block. I'm going to explain you about the inode block. What does mean by the inode blocks? Inode block is a just like an index table. Whenever you open a book, so see that okay, this topic is located on this page number, or this topic is located on this page number, something like that, right? In similar way, what happens is that the inode will keep all the information about your files and directories. So where is your file is located exactly on the hard drive? Example, say that you have the tracks, you have the blocks, and you have the sectors and all the information. This inode will keep the information about your file like this. Whenever you create a 10 MB file on your system, which says that this file is started from this inode, which means that from this inode number to this inode number, which means that this block to this block, the file has been occupied. So this many blocks, the file has been occupied, and the file name is this one, and the file owner is this one, and file group name is this one, and the times created timestamp and its file size. So this is the information will be kept under the inode block. So that's why whenever you create, actually example say that 10 GB if you create the size, but exactly you will not get the 10 GB in size, but you will get something around 9.8 or 9.9, something like that. So where is that the remaining size went? So the remaining size will be occupied by these blocks. So these blocks will keep some data into the hard disk itself by which is identifying your files and directories, all the information about. Whenever you say that 4096 byte is the default block size of the inode, and if you say that 15 data blocks, so wherever you say that the fourth one is the 15 data blocks, if you say 15 data blocks equal to one inode, okay, and if data size is more than 100 MB, block size is going to be 4096 bytes of your inode. If the data size is less than 100 MB, then that's going to be 1024 bytes. That's how your inodes are maintained within the file system to identify where are the files are located and directories are located and their permissions, owners, group name, size, and timestamps. Let's see that if I create a soft link, how it affects or how it's going to be create this pointing to the systems. Example, say that this is your hard drive, and example, say it's going to be a soft link example. So I have a virginal file. The virginal file is exactly located, maybe the virginal file is located on inum number 401, and my hard disk data on the hard disk is this one, which means that virginal file I have, the virginal file is exactly located on a hard drive, the inode block number, the inode number is 401. If I create a soft link to this virginal file, which means that example this say that it's a shortcut to my original file, and the soft link inode number would be a 427, example say in this case. Why? Because Your original file is created on 401, but whenever you say that the soft link, the shortcut is going to be created on another block, the block number would be 427 example. So, but what this soft link will be pointing to? The soft link inode number is pointing to the original file. So if my original file is deleted, there is no meaning of soft link, which means that if you delete a original file, there is no soft link. Which means if you access the soft link after deleting the original file, you cannot see any data on the soft link. That is called a soft link in example. So we are going to see the practical in a similar way. So let's go and see the practical after I explain the hard link example over here. So this is example over here is that hard link example. How? So I have original file. The original file is pointing to the inode called 401 in this case. And if I create the hard disk space is located on the 40 number inode. And if I create a hard link to the original file, the hard link also pointing to the same inode number. So if you say that what does mean by the original file and the hard link file is you cannot identify after creating the hard link, say that okay, this is my hard link or this is my original file or this is my original file or this is my hard link. So that's how if you create a hard link, what happens? So the hard link, whenever you update the original file, the hard link file will also be updated. Whenever you update the hard link files, the original file also be updated. So that is called the hard link file, and the original file is pointing to the same inode numbers. Okay, that is called a hard link in example. Let's see that the practical how it goes. So we can create a soft link and hard link and find out the scenarios over here. But why you create a soft link? Your example, a important code, if you are writing some code on some file, so if you want to do that backup of that one continuously, so if you create a copy of it, which means that the copy will be not updated until unless you type the copy command and update the next file. But this hard link file, the linking the file will be updated as soon as you type the some text and save it, then it will be saved to the hard link file. So that is the useful case in this hard link useful case scenario over here. Let's see some practical. Just going to create a directory called links. So I'm just going to jump into the links file over here, links directory over here. And in this, I'm just going to create a two files. Example, say that soft link, and say I'm just going to create a hard link. Now, if I would like to create a soft link from soft link file to the any other file, so within the same directory you can create, or within the different directories also you can create. The command you can use is called ln-s. Ln in the sense, the command is going to be useful to create a linking files. Okay, first of all you have to give the source file. So I'm just, in this case I'm going to give the source file called soft link, and I'm going to give the soft link name as a destination different one. So I'm just going to say link to soft, something like that. So now my soft file linking, soft linking has been completed. If I go to verify the file using the stat of this file starting, so here you can see that the file name is soft link and the size is 0 bytes and the blocks are occupied 0 and the IO blocks is 4096 and it's a regular file. And say that what is the inode number of that one. The inode number one is 123 is the inode number, and it does not have more than one links. Okay, when it is accessed and modified and user permission, all the stuff. Okay, let's go ahead and see that what is this file says. So this file says is that the file name is linked to soft, but which is showing over here is that which is not a original file which is linking to this file. Okay, now its size is 8 and inode number is 126. You can see that this is this inode number is 123 and this inode number is 126. Okay, that's different over here. And let's go ahead and do some content on the soft link. Okay, testing soft link file. I just save this one and cat the soft link one. Okay, there is a content and do a cat on the link to soft. So there is a same content on both the files. If I delete, example, say that I'm just deleting this soft link over here and go ahead and see this file. So there is no such a file or directory. So like this, if you do a soft link after deleting the original file, the file is going to be nothing. So just a shortcut kind of stuff. But if you create a hard link file, the hard link file, if you delete the original file also, the hard link file is going to be exist. Example, say over here, say hard link, say to link to hard link. Example, say that here the link has been created. If you want to create a hard link, you can use ln and provide the file name and destination, file name, source and destination. Now you can go ahead and see that what is the difference over here. So the stats says hard link is the inode number is 125, file is hard link and there is no size and zero blocks occupied by this file. There is a links, two links. Now go ahead and see that to hard link, see this, we says to hard link and size is zero, the inode number is 125 and inode number is 125. There is no difference if you say that. If I update the file, go to hard link and say testing hard link file and save this one and cat the hard link. Example, say cat hard link and cat to hard link. So both are containing the same size. If I go back and see again this stats for both the files, sorry, too hard. So you can see that the size is 23, the size is 23, the inode number is 125, the inode number is 125. In case of deletes, what happens? If I delete a hard link file over here, if I do a cat to this file, it still exists. So that's the difference between the soft link and hard link. I hope you understand soft linking and hard linking. This you can look it up the description. If you have any other commands which you can create the soft link and hard link, please comment on the comment box. Thanks for watching. Stay tuned. Please subscribe to the channel for more upcoming videos and courses. Please follow us on social networking sites. If you have any technical related questions, you can ask.